Okay, so I'm back. Knitted two of them, the small fries, and then threw them in this temporary breeder tank for the moment. Must have over 20 of them right now. I'm not sure how many more she's going to give birth to, but she's still doing her thing, so I'll just wait. I think I've been sitting here for at least an hour. Let's see. Oh, this little breeder net I actually really like. It's cheap. It's about $6-7. You can get them at PetSmart. I order a couple breeders net from eBay before that didn't work so well. It was bigger, but the hole was also bigger, so the baby was able to either swim out or get sucked out by the bigger fish. So $6-7 at PetSmart. I'll just keep an eye on her, see how much more she'll, you know, release. Hopefully not too many more, so I can start removing the baby fries back into here. I done this once before where I actually have like three of them that was pregnant at the same time that was giving birth, and I tried putting them on in something like this, and it didn't work out so well because even though, oh, there's one. Let's see if I can see it there. Nope, that's not it. Thought I saw one. Oh, there it goes. It's on. It's over there. See, there's a little one. Okay, back to the story is three of them in there, pregnant at the same time, all giving birth. Well, as soon as one of them releases one baby, the other, and the original mom wouldn't really eat them, but the other mom that are also giving birth will turn around and eat them. So it's kind of hard when you have three of them at the same time. But see, these guys are just waiting. And the reason I like this breeder net from PetSmart is the holes are really, really tiny. So no matter what, the babies cannot be sucked out by the bigger fish. Babies can't escape. And just set two of them up and you can just net them and transfer them over. That's how I got a high success rate of raising guppies.